viewers, and a warm welcome to today's edition of the program Perspective. Today, I'll be moving away from politics and be looking to motivate someone out there who is looking to hear something, to start something. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Today on the program, I have a special guest. His name is Mr. Remy Daniels. He is the practical life essence coach and an entrepreneur. Mr. Remy, you're welcome to the program.
Thank you for having me.
Okay. I'll go straight away and I'll ask, as a youth or a Nigerian, in the face of the challenges we're having, be it the economy, and no matter how we want to look at it, Nigeria has come out of a recession, but things have not yet stabilized. We have not got to where we used to be, considering that the exchange rate is still high and so many challenges the youth encounter. How does one stay motivated even after trying a lot of things and those things fail?
Okay, Nkiru, thank you so much for that question. And, you know, this question is the issue of youth restiveness, the issue of the problem we are facing in the country today, and the youth carrying the most burden as it is today, which, of course, they are supposed to be probably the ones trying to fix the problem because it's now their responsibility. But it's been there a long time. You understand, and probably again before you can understand how to carry on in a situation like this, like we said, there's a problem in Nigeria, which of course I see the government trying to put their heads together, trying so much to make sure they solve this problem. But of course, it is not an easy thing to do. You understand, we've had this problem of mindset shift, you get, and it has gotten into the minds of the youth. You understand, it's been there, the issue of unemployment has been there, the issue of lack of electricity, the issue of so many of those things that has been there that probably the government is supposed to have been able to sort out before now. The people, the youths, the ones on ground are far bigger than even the solution you're going to give to them. You understand? So it simply means that it will take the government like a long time before they can actually achieve what it is they say they want to achieve, especially for the youth. Now, in taking the issue of unemployment, you understand, what I say to young people out there most time when I meet them is, okay, these are issues that has been there a long time. You understand? But if the youth of those days, those who were below 40 years back, if they had taken the bull by the horn long time ago by trying to create using their ideas, using their brain, using their opportunities to create a solution, there won't be much problem today. Now, we've gotten here now, and everybody knows here there are issues, there are problems going on. The issue of Boko Haram is there, the issue of the Shiites coming into Abuja and doing all of those things. And as far as I'm concerned, most of those people that you see there are young people. You understand? If you ask most of them, some of them are hungry. Some of them are not just hungry because they want to eat food. They are hungry because they want power. Now, the problem again we have with the youth again is the youth nowadays are not even fighting for. They are not fighting for the nation. They are fighting for an individual. Do you understand? So it means everybody is fighting to survive. So if you're fighting to survive, it simply means that you must be able to feed first before you have the ability or the power to say you want to actually survive in a situation that we find, or in an environment that is chaotic as it is now. Now, what am I saying? It is time for the youth to change their mindset. It is time for people who are out there. The youth cannot do it alone. The elders cannot do it alone. The youth are clamoring for power now. So it means that if they get there, the question I ask most of them is, if you finally get there, you want to be there, if you finally get there, what can you do? It is easier said when these people are the ones there and you're criticizing them, you're shouting about them not doing enough for you. But as an individual, what can you do for yourself? What can you do for Nigeria? So the mindset needs to shift from what can people do for me or what can the government do for me to what can I do for the government. If I start thinking like, what can I do for the government, what can I do for my country specifically, then I'll be able to create an environment where as a young person I can employ some other people that are going to work under me. I will motivate them to, you understand, it means that then in turn they will motivate some other people. So if we can have that chain, then we'll be able to get somewhere.
Speaking about that, there are youths that have tried. They have tried to, you know, they say these things, you should acquire skills, you know, don't wait for the government to do things for you. And they've gone out of their way to actually acquire those skills. But the environment is not favorable, like we mentioned, the electricity. Some have had to shut down their businesses because lack of power. How do they generate their capital? Is going on into the production, and there is nothing like, and if you don't make profit in a business, how will the youth continue in that direction?
Some of the problem we have with some of the youth we have today is nobody wants to sacrifice anymore.
Okay.
Do you understand? Now their desire, the desire they have is conflicting with the main interest. Do you understand? So it means that every young person today wants to be rich. But the understanding is, are you ready to go through the process? There are processes laid down for all of these things. If you're going to set a goal for yourself, I wish every youth, whether educated or not, and our major problem is the lack of education. You understand? Most people do not even understand what it means to set a goal. You understand? If you can actually set a goal and say to yourself, okay, this year 2018, I want to achieve XXX, and be sure the goal you're trying to set is achievable. Don't go and set a goal that this year 2018, I want to buy a Rolls Royce. Do you understand? You don't have a job, you don't have a business that is going to fetch you that money. Do you get? But you've set a goal that's way beyond, not even around what it is that you need to achieve. Do you get? Now, but if you set a goal and say, okay, this year 2019 or 2018 or come 2019, between January and February, I want to be able to have a farm. I want to be able to set up a business within my area. And again, you see, sometimes you look at the factors surrounding where you are. You don't just set up a business, you understand that. Of course, I know these are major problems. Like I talk about the electricity, I know there are major problems. Everybody is facing that problem. We cannot solve that problem in one day. If we can understand that thing, that this problem, it's a general problem. It's a problem that has been there. You understand? And we have come to meet the problem. We will try our best to move into the next way so that we can see how far we will go. You understand? To be able to see that, okay, we have done our best. Do you understand? So it means that if you set up a business and you're not making profit now, there are other businesses you can set up that you can actually make something from. That is why it is good to go. When I talk about process, it means working with people who have been in the system. Working with people, asking questions like, okay, how did you make it from where you were when you were younger, even though then things were better than now? You understand? How did you make it? How were you able to survive it? You understand? And it means that we all cannot do the same business. Nigerians, the youths today are fond of copying from those that are already up there. Do you get? Somebody who has set a business for 30 years and now he's making so much money. Somebody is seeing him today. A young person is seeing the person today, and you just say, okay, today I want to be as rich as this person. Do you know what this person went through before getting here? Do you get? So if we understand the problem, we all know the problem of Nigeria. If I start mentioning them, we won't leave here today. But of course, if as a person, I can't go now and say, I want to set up ice block business in a place where I know there is no electricity. How much am I going to sell those ice blocks? That means I'm going to have to generate power by myself by bringing a generator. And you know, the cost of having to buy diesel or fuel and all at the end of the day. So how much do you intend to make? So there are other things that you can do. There are other things that your brain can think of, you understand, that we can do that will actually help the situation. So for me, if the young people can work on their mindset, to understand that solving a problem is not one day, it's a process, and you must finish one stage before you move to the next stage. Then, of course, definitely, before you get to the final place, you will know that you would have been able to achieve something. So we need to speak to ourselves. As an individual, I need to speak to myself and see that, okay, what are my desires? What are my needs? Are these things achievable? Why do I want to drive exotic cars in an environment where I know that to buy fuel or to maintain that car is a problem? Why do I want to set up a business? I get a loan from the government. This government might not have been giving them. The past government have been giving loans to support small businesses. But how did people manage those businesses that today everything has turned to like this? We're not managing. You understand? So the problem, some of those problems, we create them. They were created from the past that our mindset that we saw the money was plenty, the resources were plenty, and we're wasting it. There are so many things out there that one can do that nobody is looking at because they are menial jobs, they are dirty things to do. But people are making money from all of the system. I'm going to give you a typical example. I was speaking to my barber, the guy cutting my hair and everything, and I ask him monthly, how much do you take home? He says sometimes it takes home 120,000 naira, and a university graduate will not take in 120,000 naira except you have gotten to a level. Do you get? But he doesn't know how to manage his 120,000 naira. And when he said that to me, I was shocked. Like, so how do you make it? He said because for every 1,000 naira that they pay or more and everything, he gets like 30% or 40%. That they keep for him and pay him every week. You get? So he gets this money. He doesn't do anything with it. He doesn't reinvest the money. He doesn't do anything. Those are skills that fetch you money, and nobody's looking at all of those things.
Well, we'll take a quick break now. When Brown will return, we'll continue with the interview with Mr. Remy Daniels. Please stay there. You're welcome back from that break. Before we went on the break, we were speaking with Mr. Remy Daniels, the practical life excellence coach and also an entrepreneur. So, Mr. Remy Daniels, there's a better judgment, and there's clearly the path that leads to self-destruction. But you find out that youths readily go for the path that leads to self-destruction. I'll give you an example, the protest that took place in Abuja recently. Those were, like you said, mainly youth. That was a self-destructive path. Why do you think youths go, young people go for those kind of things?
You know, most of those people have been brainwashed. Okay. That's one part you need to understand. Somebody, they already sold an idea to them. They sold an ideology to them that if they do this, this is what they will get at the end of the day. And these guys didn't just get into this today. It's been there. They grew up understanding that path. So for them, they see it as, okay, they are ready to sacrifice themselves for the truth. Meanwhile, it is not the truth. You understand? It's the same people who have taken them to that path that will have to bring them back, because it takes a lot and processes to bring back somebody who has gone insane. Sometimes, or most times, it's you have to go medical on them. You can't gain them back immediately. Okay. Do you understand? So they have they have a mindset already sold to them from when they were just 5 years old or 4 years old. And that is what they grew up with. And they've been there for 20 years, they've been there for 15 years. Now, for them, they are doing the right thing. So they don't mind. What is the truth to them is what has been sold to them.
You spoke about in the beginning to start a business or something. Mm. You know, they're life, the complexities of life, they are just so much, and at times it's now where the person of where do I start from? It's a problem for most people. So what will be your answer to simplify things and start somewhere?
First and first, you need to know what you want.
Okay.
Now, in knowing what you want, you need to ask questions. You need to get somebody who's going to help you break down that thing you said you want. You understand? So until you get that understanding, in fact, you need to go to that field and see those people who have been there before, who have gone through that process and they have succeeded in doing the same idea and the same business. Then you can now say, okay, that's where you now say, okay, you want to start. And I talked about you finding yourself in an environment that is not yours. I talk about you finding yourself among people that are not there to attend, to motivate you. Motivation doesn't come from me talking on TV right now. It comes from individual conversation with one person.
Really?
Yes, you need to find that person. But what is most important in all of this is you have to make sure God is your number one in everything that you're doing, so that you'll be able to define your purpose and the reason why you want that thing you want. Now, getting ready after knowing all of these things, getting ready to get this thing done, you get, is assuming it's a business. Of course, you know, you need to get your capital ready, you need to get all of those things ready and everything. Most people do not even know how to write a business proposal. They don't even know they need to get help to write a better business proposal for them to get a loan or to get support from somewhere. And you know, there is the issue of trust amongst people. There are people you have had probably either not deal, probably you've had just maybe some acquaintances with them and everything. You send them money or they ask you to borrow money from you and all. And at the end of the day, they did not fulfill their part. You know, that kind of person will not walk up to you again tomorrow and say, I need money to start a business, because the trust is not there anymore. You understand? So the issue of integrity is there. So that when you walk into anywhere, people will be able to look at you and say, okay, I can actually invest so much money. You know, the kind of entrepreneurs we have now, nobody wants to invest money on failures. They want to fail by themselves, but they want to look at you like, okay, if I give you 1 millionaire, what can you do with 1 millionaire? Even though this is your idea and everything. Okay, if I'm giving you 1 million, I'm not gonna give you 1 million as a loan. I'm gonna give you as investment. So if your idea, the idea you're putting on the table is ideal, if your idea is sellable, then trust. You definitely at some point get somebody to support you or get funds from somewhere, then you can start.
People don't want to invest in failures. But again, you say, or people say, when you fail or when you try, you have to try again.
Yes.
Why can't you, have failed?
Failure is not just failure. There are businesses that you fail from, right? It's your fault. You understand? But if you're passionate about what you're really bringing on the table, it means that if you try, even employment, if you try to get a job and you can't get a job somewhere, you understand? You still can try again. That's what I mean by even when you fail, you need to try again. You understand? If you try to set up a business and it's not working for you, and you fail along the line, you understand? Sometimes it's for you to learn a lesson, so that when you're about to start another business or you want to go back to the same business, you understand your problems. I talked about desire when we started. Our desires are conflicting with our interest. You understand? So the reality will not be there, because desires are those energies that push you into loving what is more luxury than what can actually fetch you what you can use as an investment. You understand? So you want to live a good life. Like I said, you want to live a good life, but you don't want to work to end a good life. You get, so as soon as you do one, that's why even businesses are failing. If you ask most of these people that are failing, you ask them, they've gotten business. We all have equal opportunities. So many of those opportunities out there. But most people do not even understand those opportunities. They do not know this is an opportunity. What do? They mess with it. You get, so it means that if you do a deal today, or somebody even does, you get from somewhere, somehow you get 100,000 naira. For most of us, the first thing we're thinking of is how to recharge our phone, how to buy the best clothes, you understand? But there are other priorities. There are things you can do with your 100,000 that will fetch you another smaller money. That part, what you get from your 100,000 can buy you those things gradually. I have a friend that nowadays, most of the people that I started business with those days, most of them, the first money they made, even in real estate and all, the first thing they did was to buy a very expensive car. Now, if you buy a very expensive car, when you're supposed to in turn invest that money into other deals, you know, again, we lose focus in what we're doing. And that's what's affecting the youth too, because nobody is telling them the right thing to do. They look at those out there using the best cars and everything, instead of see that, okay, if you do the first business and you make good money, instead of buying a very good car, yes, you can. Car is important, but you don't need to buy that very expensive car now. Invest that money. You can have streams of business. You can have different kind of businesses. I love what some young people are doing now. You understand? They realize that at a particular time, the business they are doing will not sell when it comes to a time, or people would have gotten into the business and the business is oversaturated. So they quickly use the money or the profit or whatever it is they've gotten from here to move into another business. So that when this one is not making the money again, they already have something new to do. If our youth can grow like that, if you make your first million or your first 100,000, invest it so that when you have something to fall back on.
Or the first 20,000.
Yes, you know, regardless, any amount. Yes. So all of these things I've said all revolve around the mindset. So if we can help the youth arrange their mind, of course they need to be ready too. If we can help them rearrange their mind, they will understand that fighting for somebody, you understand, is not the way forward. It will not even move this country forward. If you have the country, your country or the nation at heart, you will know that destroying things here will not make any sense. You understand? They will know that we need to reinvest in this country. Everybody that is running away to America or those foreign countries and all and everything, those people sacrificed. Those people paid the price. But are we willing to pay the price too here? So you must be willing to pay the price.
So Mr. Rami, when someone starts something or business or any venture and suffers a setback, what is your advice to such a person or even a person starting afresh or changing habits from the self-destructive path? What's your advice?
My advice is simple and straight. Never give up. There's every possibility in every business. There's every possibility that at some point there'll be a downtime. And those downtimes are the times that lead to failure. And sincerely, failure is part of the process. The reason why people have succeeded today is actually because they failed before because of one mistake or carelessness. And they were able to learn from their mistakes. Now it has become their experience. And they are willing to start again. And they are willing not to give up. We need to stop listening to too many voices. If you're starting a new business and it's a passion, you have people that you can talk to. You have professionals that you can talk to. But people tend to speak to just anybody. And because you're speaking to too many people, you have too many voices going into your brain, confusing you from, most especially if you don't have a mind of your own. Most people do not even have a mind of their own. So even, you see, there are signs while you're in that business, while you're already in that business, that shows that this business is actually profitable. But of course, I made mistakes. Those mistakes can be costly, but you still have opportunity to start again. Most people do not even have opportunity to start again. So if you know you have the opportunity to start again, then that means that's an indication for you to know that, okay, this is the time to correct every mistakes. But are people willing to understand that they made a mistake? That's it. So if you're starting a new business, the same mindset, walk into the business with the same mindset that I'm going to succeed. I'm not going to be careless with my funds. I'm not going to be careless with the business. If I'm supposed to show at a particular time, show at a particular time. If you have your investment, you're already there in the business, I mean, then you can bring in people. Then you see, we need to start learning how to empower people around us with ideas, with everything that we have, so that when we're not there, these are the people that looks like you you have mentored them along the line, you understand? They now know how to do business. That's why sometimes you see some bosses will do business, but the people coming behind will not succeed doing the same business. But of course, the same business, the parents have come to drop for them. Most rich people, their children will eventually, it's just, not all of them do, but it's happening very well. Their children are always wasting. They are wasting what they worked for so many years, because they did not understand what the process was. They didn't even understand what the man went through before he made the money. They just came, they met wealth, and they are flying into it. As you see all this in our entertainment industry, these guys are doing well. They go there, they sing, even though sometimes people say the songs are not making sense and everything, but these guys are making their money. You understand? And Nigeria, we like to criticize a lot. When we're supposed to criticize constructively, help somebody, not criticize to condemn somebody. Of course, people are making money from condemning, because when they condemn, people respond, and from there, they gain popularity. But the truth is, are we helping? Because at the end of the day, what we're doing gradually is, we're killing the system gradually. But when you can criticize constructively, and at the same time, advise people, after saying all of those things, then we'll get to a better place. That's the only way we can build this nation. And that's the only way we can help the government.
So, on a lighter note, you're known to love your Mondays. What is that all about? And how can the youth benefit from that?
We talked about the economy when we started. Like, okay, the problem, there's so much problem out there and everything. And, you know, people are dying of... people are dying of very simple sicknesses and all. And what's why? Because of simple thing, because of stress. Do you understand? Now, you know TGIF, thank God it's Friday. Everybody loves Friday, because Friday you will enjoy yourself. You create that fun. It's a mindset thing. You create that fun. And once it's Sunday, after church or whenever, because you rest on Sunday and it's time to get ready for work on Monday, it becomes an issue, because we've relaxed from Friday till... Fine, I was born on Monday. That's one. Then two. There's so much negative energy going on. Then how do you intend to survive in the midst of these negative energies? Do you understand? How do you intend to survive? How? Then create a mindset. So that's why I created that I love my Mondays. People do not like Mondays because they know it's work, work, work. But they are forgetting that what you set on Monday, whatever you set on Monday will last you till Friday. So why don't you make your Monday a sweet one? There are ways you can work. You can work in the office and still have fun in the office. And you're working. You create it yourself, it's you. It's a form of exercise. It's a way to change the mindset. It's a way to have a positive mindset about Mondays. It's a way to have a positive mindset about yourself. It's a way to be able to communicate and actually connect with people. You understand? Because people are always wondering, okay, why are you always like happy you have created? I said, yes, I have to do that for myself. Nobody will create it for me if I don't do that for myself. So Monday is special. Everybody is seeing it as negative. Let's take our mind and see what Monday has got to offer us. And I've been gaining from Mondays. So I tell everybody, change your mindset about what you think about a particular day or somebody. If you change your mindset about it and be positive about that day, it will be productive for you.
Thank you very much, Mr. Remy. I must say I've learned a lot, and I hope viewers, you taking a lot from that interview. Remember, the program is about changing mindsets so that things invariably translate to the better good of us, our immediate family, and the society as a whole. Till I come your way next week, remember, you can always call the numbers on your screen for advert placement and for sponsorship and participation on the program. I'm Kiro Mini. Stay out.